How's it going, YouTube? It's Noah, back again with a new type of video. And in this video, I'm going to be doing something I've wanted to do for a while. I'm going to be doing some ASMR. So, yeah. This is really a test video. I don't know how it sounds. Hopefully it sounds okay. But, yeah. I'm going to be reading some fanfiction in this one because anyone who knows me knows I'm addicted to fanfiction, and hopefully I can find one that's, I don't know, less than 1,000 words, and I'll read it to you guys, and I'll link it in the description as well, so you guys can go check it out. Please leave a review, because that's a nice thing to do. So I'm going to switch over. Alright, it should still be working. Can you see my cursor thing? Can you hear me click? Does that sound nice? Now, be going to Dragon Ball Z, because that's my thing right there. And if you guys like this stuff, let me know. I could do different kinds of things, but this one I'm just starting out with something that is more familiar to me. But you know, if this works out well, we should be able to do some more, and I would be very happy to do some more. But this is more of a, as my dog shakes himself in the background. This is more of a test video, honestly, so if you guys enjoy this, I'll do some more. So, you know, let's see what we got here. Spirit Bomb. Vegeta had become much more than a rival long ago. Published May 30th, 2018. 839 words. Did he miss Kakarot? Of course not. Let's see here. I'm looking for a good description. A description that that pops out to me, if you will. This man, Dreamy Souls, apparently likes these homosexual relationships, which, I mean, fair play to you, buddy. Whis' statement was so surprising that Beerus had spit out was left of the truth. Vegeta and Goku together? What kind of joke is that? Okay, actually, I have an idea. I take off the parent thing, it's 1 in 79. I just have to find, let's see, published February 7th. Okay, it's Spanish, I don't know Spanish. Okay, I'm looking for something here. Okay, no, I don't care about you. Goku and Vegeta share a personal moment. Oh, here we go. Published August 14th, 2018. Complete. Okay, let's see what this is. So like him, a Dragon Ball Z fanfic. One shot. Oh, here we go. And Goku and Vegeta. Just a cute little short story about Goku and Vegeta's blooming relationship. May make this part of a one-shot series. Rating is PG, just kissing. Nothing major. I really am trying to get back to writing DBZ Yaoi stories. Let me know what you think. Enjoy. Alright, thank you, Masochist in Tango. I will leave his link in the description, as well as the link to his fanfic, so if you guys could go in, check him out. Maybe leave a review. I'd really appreciate that. I would leave a review, but I don't know what my account is anymore, so maybe I'll try and do that later. Alright, here we go. This is going to be very interesting. He wasn't sure how things had ended up this way. His mind was a total blank on the current situation he found himself in. All that was going through his cloudy mind was a chant of the other man's name. Kakarot. 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 This chant continued in his mind as soft lips pressed down against his own. Goku's hands were roaming over his body, sliding across his stomach, stroking his hips, grabbing at his ass. Vegeta tilted his head to the side, panting. Cheeks flushed deeply as Goku continued kissing him on his neck now. Goku nibbled at the soft skin, teeth scraping lightly against tail flesh, sucking on the other man's Adam's apple, eliciting a high-pitched moan out of Vegeta. Kakarot! Vegeta sighed out, closing his eyes and enjoying the sensation. Cheeks flushed a deep pink and stirring, starting in his spandex shorts. Goku seemed to snap out of his trance when Vegeta spoke, and he leaned back to look Vegeta in the face, grinning that ever-so-wide Son trademark smile. Glad you seem to be enjoying yourself, Vegeta, Goku purred into his ear. Vegeta opened his eyes again, face flushed. Yet he didn't have a retort for Goku. He was speechless on what had just occurred. His mind was also boggled that he wanted more. God, What am I getting myself into? You. Vegeta stuttered out, Baka. Goku leaned down close to his face again, smiling as he kissed and nipped at Vegeta's neck again. Vegeta, face still flushed deeply, let the man continue exploring his body with his hands. He felt himself nearly go limp in Goku's arms, and when he realized the moans aloud were coming from his mouth, he blushed even deeper. Goku seemed to enjoy that, solidified the idea as he spoke. You're really cute when you blush, Vegeta, he purred to the other man leaning close to his ear. I'd love to see more of it. He nipped Vegeta's ear softly, then rose up to his full height, towering over the smaller man. He turned away from Vegeta and walked away, tail swishing behind him with excitement. Vegeta couldn't believe Goku had been so bold as to do that, to take charge over him, assert his dominance with a seal of this. It had been so out of character for the larger man, so Saiyan-like. Vegeta placed the gloved hand against his tingling, but suddenly a memory came full force to the front of his head and taking him back into the past. The taller man shifted his long mane of hair over his shoulder and smiled at Vegeta's flushed face, flashing his canines in a display of love. You're so cute when you blush, Uji-sama. A pair of lips again sealed over his own, and Vegeta found himself up against the wall, hands fisted in the taller man's hair as they pressed their bodies together. After several moments, they parted, panting. I'd like to see it more, the deep voice of the man rumbled through his chest, nearby making Vegeta moan aloud as he felt it. Vegeta came out of his flashback and placed a hand against his swollen lips. So like him. Damn you, Kakarot. Yet despite that, he found himself trailing after the other Saiyan. So like him. So that's it for now, folks. Let me know what you thought. If you like it, maybe I can write a few more one-shots. Thanks, everyone. Well, you know what, Mr. Masochist M-Tango? I enjoyed this very much. This is a very interesting one to do for my first ASMR video. And you know what? This man right here, he doesn't seem to be very active, which is a shame. But I'm still going to link it in the description. Go check my man out, Masochism Tango. This dude, he did a good job. He's a nice American boy. Joined July 25th, 2015. Oh, he likes Supernatural as well. Well, yeah, no, I used to like Supernatural too. This only has one review. Now, let's see what it says. I loved it, so cute. Thank you, AI. I might leave a review as well. Yeah, so I'm gonna link this man in the description. This is just a test video. I could do more stuff in the next one. Read more fan fiction or do other things, you know? I just thought I'd give ASMR a try. I don't know how it went. But, yeah, I'm just gonna do it for this video, guys. I hope you somewhat enjoyed. I hope this was at least interesting to listen to, if not relaxing. And yeah, I don't really have much else to say, so if you want to see some more of this, let me know, and I'll do it. So thank you guys very much for watching, and I'll see you next time. Have a great day.